technique of internal decompression for spinal stenosis in lumbar spine. Lumbar canal stenosis is a very common problem, characterized by narrowing of the spinal canal, which may or may not be associated with prolapsed intervertebral disc. It is more common in the lateral recesses and less common in the central part of the canal. The bony spinal canal is divided into two parts. The medial part is occupied by the dura, and the lateral part, which is occupied by the nerve root, emerging from the dura and exiting through the foramen. This is the main topic of discussion in this technique. The entrapment of the nerve root in the foramen is common in lateral recess stenosis, and it can be best visualized on the sagittal cuts of MRI. Usually, in this pathology, two nerve roots are involved. The exiting nerve root is compressed by upward migration of the superior facet, and the traversing nerve root is compressed by coronal orientation of the inferior facet. Lumbar canal stenosis can be essentially characterized into two phases. Phase 1 is the beginning of the process. It is an unstable phase and less commonly seen. The motion segment in this phase is unstable and needs stabilization with posterior lumbar interbody fusion. Phase 2 is the delayed phase with sequelae of the process. This is the most commonly encountered phase. The spine is not unstable anymore and is stabilized in deformity. The choice of operative procedure for this phase is internal decompression of spinal stenosis.